A very warm welcome to all of you. Myself, Kashish Talwani, welcomes you back to my channel, Simplifying Business Studies. So this is going to be the third session of Chapter 2 of Class 11, Forms of Business Organizations. In our previous video, we understood the features of sole proprietorship. So in this video, we will understand the advantages or the merits of sole proprietorship form of business. Before I go forward, please like this video and subscribe to my channel. So let us quickly start our session. Just to recapitulate what we understood in our previous session, let us understand that. So we understood the features of sole proprietorship, which were single ownership, no sharing of profit and loss, one man's capital, limited liability, less legal formalities, and one man control. Single ownership means that this form of business is owned by one individual. There is no sharing of profit and loss. He enjoys all the profits of the business and suffers all the losses by himself only. He invests the capital and starts the business, and he has unlimited liability. That means if any loss occurs to this business, his personal property can be used to pay off the debts of the business. There are very less or like no formalities to start this form of business. And there is one man control. That means this form of business is managed by one person. So absolute flexibility, absolute control is there. So now in this session, as I previously told you, that we will understand the merits or advantages or benefits of sole proprietorship. So the very first merit of sole proprietorship is that it is easy to form and it is absolutely easy to close or dissolve. So a sole proprietorship kind of business is easy to form. It doesn't involve any legal formalities in setting up of this kind of business, and also it is not governed by any specific law. So the sole proprietor can close its business whenever he desires without any legal formalities, and definitely he has to pay off his debts if he has taken any. So we can say that this form of business is absolutely easy to form and absolutely easy to close or dissolve. Next is direct incentive. That means there is an absolute direct relationship between the efforts and the rewards. How much effort a sole proprietor puts into his business will be paid off by the rewards he will get. So that means there is no lag between efforts and rewards. How much efforts he will put, he will definitely get those rewards. And he is the person who will directly enjoy all the rewards of the business. So the next point is flexibility or independent control. Here, the business is all managed by this one person who is called sole proprietor. He is his own boss. There is no sharing of any kind of rewards. There is full control, full privacy, and he's the single owner. So that means all decisions are taken by proprietor himself, and he is not supposed to consult anyone. So this is an absolute flexibility, absolute independence for him, that he can take care of his business in the way he wants. He doesn't have to ask anyone. He doesn't have to go and consult anyone for taking decisions of his business. So he is the decision maker of the business. Sole beneficiary of all the profits. That means because he is the one who is managing all the business, who is taking all the risk for the business, so it is an absolute truth that he will enjoy the profits by himself. So all the profits belong to the proprietor only, and there is no sharing of these profits. Personal touch, that means this is that one person, sole proprietor, who manages his work by his own. So the person he deals with, like his customers, his suppliers, public, etc., so can be given some kind of personal attention. So definitely this kind of person maintains personal bonding with customers, suppliers, etc. So this always brings certain benefits to the business. So we can say that all work is managed by proprietor himself, and he can maintain personal bonding with customers and suppliers, etc. We can understand this through an example that when we go to a market, maybe to buy clothes or maybe to buy a phone from, so we definitely try to go to one particular shop where we find that people selling those goods are trustworthy. So this trust is always built when a business is able to maintain personal bonding with the customer. Next point is confidentiality of information or secrecy, because everything is managed, everything is taken care by one person only. So definitely secrecy is easily maintained. There is no leakage of any kind of confidential information. So everything remains in one hand and everything remains safe and sound. Sense of accomplishment, because I always say this is one person who is taking care of business. So if he is able to work well and derive some good results for the business, there is always a sense of accomplishment for this person, because everything earned by this person is earned by himself only. So definitely this will contribute to self-satisfaction, this will contribute to increase his confidence, and definitely sense of accomplishment will be brought in by this person. So next point is suitable for small scale operation. So this kind of business is a kind of business which is most suitable for small scale businesses, because there is limited capital, limited managerial efficiency. So when the business is not about to scale much, so this is the best form to go for, with least legal formalities, independent control, flexibility. So this has all the advantages to start a small scale business. So it is absolutely suitable enterprise for business requiring small capital, personal attention, and absolute control. So it is suitable form which offers opportunity for self-employment. So children, we have reached the end of this session. I hope all the topics are clear to all of you. If you have any questions or doubts, you can always write it in the comment box. Thank you so much. Have a very good day ahead.